Good evening. Thank you so much for coming out on this Saturday night to support our kids in their production of The Wonder of Christmas. You will not be disappointed. But first, we're going to have a prelude with a couple of our students who just started an orchestra and band at their elementary schools. They're going to play a little prelude for us. We're going to start with Madison Friels, who's going to play her clarinet and play Jingle Bells, followed by Isaac Alger on the viola playing Ode to Joy. Enjoy. And now Connecting Point Kids presents The Wonder of Christmas.
King and ruler. about the time Caesar Augustus ordered a census to be taken throughout the empire.
Everyone had to travel to his own ancestral hometown to be counted.
So Joseph went from the town of Nazareth up to Bethlehem in Judah, David's town, for a census. As a descendant of David, he had to go there.
He went with Mary, his fiancée, who was pregnant while they were there. She gave birth to a son, her firstborn.
She wrapped him in a blanket and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn.
Every year it's the same thing. Jesus is here, woohoo! Jesus is born, yippee! I just don't get it. What's the big deal about a baby being born around a bunch of animals?
Jesus wasn't just a baby, Isaac.
Right, Jesus' birth was such a big deal that all of heaven celebrated. Heaven celebrated? What does that even mean?
Angels appeared in the sky, praising God, announcing the birth of Jesus.
And a star shined in the sky as a sign of where Jesus had been born.
And because heaven made such a big deal about Jesus, we should too.
Listen to how our friends tell it.
There were shepherds camping in the neighborhood. They had set night watches over their sheep.
Suddenly, God's angel stood among them, and God's glory blazed around them.
They were super scared, but the angel said,
"Don't be afraid, for I'm here to announce a great and joyful event that is meant for everybody in the whole world."
Soon a whole choir of angels joined him, singing and praising God over this new little baby. That all sounds pretty unbelievable, but I wonder what it was like to see angels sing and celebrate like that.
We can show you. Singing isn't just for angels, you know.
The angels did say,
Okay, so Jesus was born to be a king. That's pretty cool, but I'm still confused about something. Who is Gloria, and why does she need so many eggshells?
No. We're singing In Excelsis Deo. That is Latin for glory to God in the highest.
In Luke 2:14, the Bible says that angels sang glory to God in the highest when they told the shepherds that Jesus was born.
That's why we sing In Excelsis Deo now, to celebrate like the angels.
Oh, I see. So the angels praised God for sending Jesus to be a king. Big deal. I'm sure he wasn't the first king ever. There's got to be a bigger reason for angels putting on the first outdoor concert for shepherds.
You're right. Jesus wasn't the first king ever.
But he came to be the king and Messiah.
What's a Messiah?
The Messiah is the promised deliverer of God's people. The Bible talks a lot about it in the Old Testament.
Jesus was the promised Messiah that people have been waiting to meet for hundreds of years.
So as soon as the angels told the shepherds where Jesus was, they couldn't help but go and find this baby the angels told them about.
When they arrived, they worshipped and adored the tiny gift from God that would change the world forever.
Much wonder lay before us. In a manger, heaven's here. Earth is longing for its Savior. Highest King, humble frame, now appear. Unto us a child.
Isaac? Jesus came to save everyone. That's why his birth is such a big deal.
Like a superhero? I don't feel like I need saving. Everyone who has ever lived except for Jesus has sinned.
And because we are sinners, we are forever separated from God.
But God had a plan from the very beginning to get rid of that separation forever.
So he sent his only son, Jesus, to die. So he sent his only son, Jesus, to be born so he could die for our sins.
Wait, die? Jesus died for my sins?
He died for all of us.
But he didn't stay dead. He defeated sin and death and rose again to life.
And because Jesus did that for us, now we can have a real relationship with God.
That's why Jesus is the best Christmas gift of all.
Whoa, that is a big deal. I guess that's why heaven went nuts. It's like everything that was broken since the beginning of time was getting fixed. Jesus wasn't just a baby.
Yeah.
Christmas is about Jesus being born, but it's so much more than that.
Jesus' birth was a miracle, but the real wonder of Christmas is what he would grow up to do for you and me.
When Jesus was born, all of heaven sang, all the earth was still.
And all the while, God was making a way to save us from sin through the gift of his Son.
Now our hearts can dance because we've been delivered by Jesus, our King, our Messiah, and our Savior.
Jesus lit up the darkness.
Jesus conquered sin and death.
And because Jesus was born, we can celebrate what our God has done.
Now that makes me want to sing like angels.
Attaboy. Yeah!
One more round of applause for these awesome kids. Special round of applause for our narrators. Go ahead and wave. Our actors. Mary and Joseph. The choir. Special recognition to Yesenia Demas for our last dance. Who you haven't seen all show is Brielle Rabel back here, our sound, our stage manager. Our sound and lights. with special recognition to Brett Beckercave, who is a first grader, and he was running everything you saw on the screen tonight. And last but not least, Jesus! All right. Friends, you may have a seat. Well, thank you again so much for coming. I know that these kids are so thankful that you are here. And everybody out here is so proud of you. You guys did an amazing job. So I hope that, yes, thank you, yes. You know, this time of year always gets me thinking. I think a lot about my childhood and how the weeks that surround Christmas, basically after Thanksgiving up and through the new year, is just a super magical time. And I think about my childhood a lot growing up and how magical it was back when I was a kid 30-some years ago. And so tonight, I just wanted to take a real quick moment just to kind of reminisce about my childhood. And you know, when I was growing up, do you guys remember when I was growing up? No. There was always one special toy. Every year, it would change. I had long-standing special gifts that I wanted every year. And there were some years that I never got that one special gift. Are you tracking with me? Kids, do you ever feel that way? That sometimes after you open all your presents on Christmas morning, there's almost a little bit of a disappointment because you made your list and you studied it and you thought really hard and you wrote everything down that you wanted, but there was just something was missing. And you know, as I got older, that magic continued all the way until into my teens. And then I kind of grew up, and I really realized, and I have to thank my grandma for this, because she instilled in me, because there was one year, I was around 9 or 10, and she recognized there was a little bit of some disappointment in my spirit. And she reminded me, you know, it's all nice and good and fun to get presents, but the presents are not what Christmas is all about. Jesus, and this is where I learned that ever-famous phrase, that Jesus is the reason for the season. And that's kind of what we've been talking about all for the past couple of months as we've been preparing for this presentation tonight, that Jesus is the reason for the season. And so kids, that's one, like, the biggest takeaway. And adults, that's the one biggest takeaway from our presentation tonight, that Jesus is the reason for the season. And I know that in our adult lives, there are times where there's a little bit of a disappointment. There's a little bit of a Christmas letdown, right? But the truth is that there doesn't have to be. I mean, yeah, life sometimes hits us really hard. But the gift of Jesus is an ongoing, everlasting love in our life that if we grasp onto that, there's no more heartfelt or heartbreak or disappointment. And so around this time, again, I just reminisce and I keep going back to my childhood. And I just remember that what my grandma instilled in me, that Jesus is the reason for the season. And the reason why we get gifts is a part of celebrating and remembering the gift of Jesus. And so while you're opening your Christmas presents in just a couple weeks, right? Remember, it's not all about the gifts. And yes, we love to get gifts. And God blesses us with those gifts. And he wants us to have those gifts. But he wants us to stay focused on him and remember that he is the one true reason for this season and why we celebrate and why we put on this show for our loved ones. All right, one last round of applause for my awesome friends up here. Before we go, I just want to take a quick moment to invite you to our Christmas Eve service. It is at 5:30. It's going to be a really special service. You won't want to miss it. We hope that you carve out time in your busy schedule to join us. And also on Christmas morning, we're going to have a 10 o'clock service here as well that you are more than welcome to join us, and we hope you do. Before we get to Christmas, next weekend, there is a really fun event that is free that we are hosting here at the church. It is called the Christmas Open, and it is free indoor family mini golf. Right? And you're like, what? Yeah, just come. It's going to be awesome. The whole church is going to be turned upside down in 2 days. It's on Friday and Saturday of next week. Come on out. Bring your kids and family and friends and neighbors and no pets. I'd bring my dog, but that wouldn't go over well. So bring everybody. It's going to be an awesome event. Check out connectingpoint.church. The Central Hub has all the information that you need. And we hope that you have a great holiday season. And what the kids are most excited for right now is the invitation for you to join us out in the lobby for cookies and cocoa. All right, so following our time here, head on out. Kids are going to stay on the stage, and the parents, if you want to come up for some Christmas photos, you can receive your kids here and then enjoy some Christmas cookies and cocoa. Thank you so much for coming. Have a great Merry Christmas.